was in the paper, they were looking for women workers to take the place of the men. And so I said to my friends, I dared them, 10 of them. I said, let's go be a welder. So it was in Quincy where we trained, but I don't know exactly what, remember where in Quincy. And after we trained, only 6 of us stayed in out of the 10. The bunch of us were out, we were having lunch, and Angie said to me, hey, Margaret, what the hell? Why don't we be a welder? I said, you kidding? I said, whoa, I don't think so. And the other girl said, yeah, and how would we get there? And what about the training? And so we sat there and we talked about it. And they were very glad to have us. And that's when we went to Quincy. Yeah, we chatted about it for a while. Whoever taught us, and I don't remember who, did a fantastic job. I wanted to be the welder. I don't know why. I just thought, oh, I want to do that. I wanted something. I wanted to help my country, for one thing, because Tony was going. And I just thought I would like it. I thought I would like the experience. Holy cow, it's freezing in the room. There's no heat. And I got steel boots, steel-toed boots, and underneath my heavy, heavy clothes is my flannel pajamas. That's how cold it was.
Okay.
And it was 7 to 3, but I worked a lot of overtime. But if they asked me to work on a weekend, as long as I had the driver in the van to go in.
Okay.
A lot of us did.
Okay.
We went whenever they asked us. A lot of times I worked 7 days a week. And then they told us exactly which ship we were working on. And then we had a lunch break. I don't even remember how, maybe it was a half an hour, because they needed the help very bad. So everybody was good. But in my group there, we're all about my age.
Okay.
No, the girls were great. We had as you saw, a lot of pictures of us, but no, everybody was good. I had no problems, none. 6 of us grew up together, you know, we knew each other so well. And the other girls that we met from, I don't know where they came from, they were great. We were just great. You know, I don't remember that, but I remember one check was $200, but I can't tell you how many hours I worked in that check.
Okay.
In my first check, I bought my mother a radio. Yeah, I did. We didn't have much. What do you want?
Okay,
security was very tight. Always told us not talk about not the ships, not about anything, because loose lips shape sink ship. They
That's
made
right.
sure when I went home and I never talked about what I did or what the day was like or anything, nothing. At the beginning, I got a few flashes. You know, that is, your eyes get all red.
Okay.
And your eyes run. But that was just at the beginning. Then I was okay. I couldn't wait to get back there to do that. His sister was my best friend.
Okay.
Okay? And she'd tell him where we're going to the movies. He'd follow us to the movies. Going roller skating, he'd follow us. I said to his sister, don't tell him where we're going. He was 4 and a half years older than me. I'm 19. You know what that is? It looks like an old man. Okay? And every Saturday night, we had a basketball and a dance.
Okay.
And every Saturday, he'd ask me to dance, and I'd say no. Okay? Finally, I broke down. I was 21 when I got married. Finally, he came home and said to me, I can't. I gotta go. All my friends are going. So he did. He's listed. No, I was patriotic. As long as it, make sure you come back.
Yes.
We had an apartment in Kingston, and I kept it all the while it was gone. I paid $35 a month, and my landlord went up to 50, and I said, I can't afford that. He said, yeah, you're a welder. We knew that at the end of the war, that we were done, and the men were coming back to get their jobs, mm-hmm. and that was okay. I stayed right to the end. Mother and Dan and I danced around the kitchen because my husband's ship, U.S. Kuratech, was headed for Japan, okay? Mm-hmm. And the war ended. So I was very lucky. Oh God, when I picked him up in Boston, I said, what the hell happened to your hair? You're bald. He had a little, and they took so many teeth out on him. I says, oh my God. But he looked great.
Okay.
And you know what? Ask her. He never talked about it. Never. Yet he was an electrician.
Okay.
So he's down the bottom. If anything happened, he would never have made it. So, like I said, I guess God was with me. Mm-hmm. And my brothers came back. He was a great guy. I wish you knew him. He was a good father, good husband. I was married 67 years.
Wow.
And he died at 93. Makes me feel good. I'm glad I did it. And we girls used to go to, aren't we glad we did that? And we'd go out and have a little drink. We were glad we did it, really. I'm so happy I did that. I just liked going in and knew I was doing something to help my country. I just liked it. I never thought about staying home and not going in or calling sick. Never did that. I wish more people would have done it, because they would have been so, you feel so good that you're doing that for your country. Mm-hmm. If it wasn't for that, I wouldn't have, what would I have done for my country? Mm-hmm. That gave me a chance.
You'd be so nice to come home to. You'd be so nice. While the breeze on high sang a lullaby.